Hello, and where's my inventory gone?
I don't know. I pressed
the key to start the video record, and it went to key items. Who the hell binds that to insert? Anyway, Capcom. What a bloody mess we've made.
Yeah.
Time to sort this out.
The last tenant was some kind of a pig.
I'd hate to be your housemate.
Actually, I do pretty much all the cleaning in my house.
No, I'll put grenades up there, I think. And the healing down here.
Makes sense.
Anyway, how are you doing?
Yeah, all right.
That is your messy sty, Mr. Pig Oink Oink.
I just watched X-Men today.
Okay, was that have been the cartoon, the first film, the second film, the third film, the fourth film, or were you reading the comic books, or the fifth film, or the seventh film, or the reboot, or the other comic book, or the other cartoon series, or what?
Well, it wouldn't have been one of the comics, because one reads a comic. It is
watch
the
a comic?
Most...
You just admire it from in a shop window somewhere.
Gaze longingly through the comic book store window. No, it was the most recent Bryan Singer-y thing with Apocalypse in it.
All right, that's a bit better. You're having to get used to this again.
You can do it, Martha. Come on.
Martha, that was my mum's name. Yeah. I love you now.
It's also my graphics card's name.
Oh, a letter. We like those.
This must be sexy, Luis.
There's an important item hidden in the falls. If you're able to get it, you might be able to get Ashley out of the church. But I'll warn you, the route to the church isn't to walk in the park by any means. They deployed what's called an El Gigante, so God bless. About what's been going on in your body. If I could help you, I would, but unfortunately it's beyond my power.
Being taken over by the gay agenda.
Oh. Hey, whoa, it's going back and forth now.
Ay, ay, ay.
Well, every time we play this game, it's an adventure.
Adventures into the land of frame. All right, now look.
Well, now, what's it doing? I'm going to run around this table until it sorts itself
it's
out.
Playing the silliest of buggers.
That's better. Right. Now we're ready.
Nothing! Hotboxed nothing!
Huh. And now, it's night time, and it's raining.
Everything else kind of makes sense, but who's running around stuffing snakes in crates?
Well, it's a weird religious cult, isn't it?
I suppose it might be a hobby.
They probably handle them.
Like...
they do snake handling.
Snakey, cratey might be a...
See them scary blue eyes in the distance?
Yeah.
That's a thing that we're gonna go to before we continue.
So it's not another giant water gecko. We're going to Mr. Salesperson's Seaside Resort
and
Boutique.
This is his beach house. He's got a lot of houses, does this bloke.
It's well invested.
Right. Yes, we know you do. And don't you just. The daily grind. Thank
you. Just once, all of his good things should be nice rugs.
Ah. I'm dying for the hard drive.
Thank you. I wonder what crazy rich people are buying these overseas. Like, is it they just like antiques, or do they specifically enjoy antiques from, like, bizarre parasite zombie war zones? I suppose that might add to the story. People like a story when they buy an antique.
Furniture reload speed, shotgun firepower, and reload speed.
Thank you. Good old pumpy boom boom.
That's what I call my willy. Yeah, reload. 5 hours already pretty good. Right, that's the shopping done.
Off we go. You know what he's playing this week?
Yeah, could you tell? I says I'm organized. Hey, you left your stores outside. I'm just going to take them. It's like that scene from The Simpsons.
Just picking up the things you've stored in these barrels property of your shop.
I'm in my panic room, do your worst. Okay, take everything.
Little light switch on and off. 22 short films about Springfield, I think that one was.
Should have guessed you'd supply that information.
It's a good app.
I need to...
I watched the director's commentary for it, like, about 3 days ago.
crazy. Yeah, there's some blue stuff we missed.
Oh well.
There's some treasures we can't access.
Yeah, we're not there yet.
And that, there's one there. Remember, there's one there.
Star treasure.
Well, bloody hell. Every time we start a new area now.
You need to, like, just reinstall Windows or some shit. I don't know what the hell's going on. Someone's replaced the water with pudding!
This is getting silly.
Oh, this fucking sucks. Come on.
Come on, you were managing this before, game. Nothing's changed.
Oh, ting!
That's more like
it's like passing an enormous shit.
Oh, God!
And then there's just more of it somehow.
Well, hey, at least I got bullet time if things get hairy early on in an area.
Good point.
See? Rough with the smooth.
Allow you to react.
Yes.
With ninja-like shit, now it's going regular again.
Oh, no. Like invincibility when you first start the area in, like, Mario or something.
Mm.
I think if memory serves, this is where we're introduced to... Yes.
A thing occurs.
Yes, this thing that happens. Oh, goodness me.
Oh, it's no great loss. The entire village only had, like, 3 heads to begin with.
I think, you know, what he gains on the swings, he loses on the roundabouts there. Yeah, I see you coming.
Yeah, the fucking head parasites are an asset, because I can. Yeah. That's gonna hit you there. Like.
Yeah. Oh, hello again. But running away.
Tactical fallback.
Yes, that's what it is.
Ah, oh, fucking finally.
Of course, if we had a flash grenade, and we have a million, then you can destroy those instantly.
Mm.
So I didn't do that.
Well, it would have been a waste at this point.
Well, yes.
You don't want to just go throwing flashbangs out willy-nilly when there's just one parasite. I mean, you really can sort of... Yeah, we do have a lot of flash grenades. It's like lucky 6.
Well, does it really happen that often that you'll get 2 parasites at once?
Yeah. Once you're in, once you're amongst the priests, I've had situations where I've had 3 or 4.
Hmm. Well, you heard it here first. Gabriel's been in situations where he's had 3 or 4 priests.
Hmm. Priests give the loveliest gifts.
Yes.
The church has a lot of money.
And then once they're done, the tabloid newspapers will give you some as well.
Yeah, it's great. It's like when your parents divorce and you get 2 Christmases.
Oh, that's handy. I didn't even mean that as a pun.
They're just in you. You've been imbued with the pun force.
Fighting to get out. It's all sort of the opposite of the problem you have with priests.
Mm. Wriggling to get free. The Gabriel Morton story.
I actually meant that the priests are fighting to get inside you.
Oh.
That dangling box looks like I could do something with it.
Yes, you do.
Not right now, though, I suspect.
Yeah, you can just... You can knock it down. It and the other one. And
can you use it tactically?
No, it just goes into the water and then it goes where it has to go. It's a puzzle.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. There's the other one, then.
Just to the right. That's already where it is. Yeah, right. See, hang on. Oh, there he is.
Yep, there it is. And I see my little red dot.
Yeah, it doesn't matter where you shoot it. The current takes it where it's got
to
be.
Don't even have to shoot it on the little thing that's holding it up.
Nah.
Just shoot it once, and apparently it was being held on with a split pin or something.
Toothpicks.
Cue Chariots of Fire. Maybe it's just a guy who only just started Steam. I haven't really played any games yet today. I've been replaying a couple of things. I've been replaying Assassin's Creed 4.
Is that the boat one?
Actually, it's the ship one.
Oh, okay.
You know the difference between a ship and a boat?
A schooner?
A ship is a boat that can contain another boat in it.
That's... Is that really the difference?
Yes.
Huh, did not know that.
And the boat is like the thing that...
The little... Yeah. The runabout that gets you to the shore.
Yeah, the jolly boat.
Ah, okay. Alright. What's a schooner?
That's a... middling-sized cargo vessel, isn't it?
I don't know. I'm asking you. You're suddenly, Captain Yahtzee nautical.
I know you're still alive. Come on. I'm ready for you.
It's when your brother gets on the trampoline first. I don't know, maybe he did die.
Where's he gone?
He went to where the frame rate...
Yeah.
He is dead.
Huh, funny that. I guess that fall was enough to kill him.
Maybe he already had a bum heart.
You'd have thought falling 10 feet onto your neck would be survivable, but... I'm just going by the Leon S. Kennedy standards.
Window, yeah.
Something's slowing this game down. Maybe it's that big wheel.
I swear in the GameCube version you had to hit the actual fucking prongs.
Well,
maybe I was wrong and I was just going to all that extra effort for nothing.
It must be something to do with the areas, because previous areas didn't slow down this much. It was just at the start.
It's been a tad chunky, this one.
You're a tad chunky.
Yeah. Taddy. Not the Snickers.
Hey! That was what we
fetch
wanted.
A high price. You're not allowed to go through there yet.
Ah, yeah. That's the whole point of this area, isn't it?
Yep. I mean, you can go up there. I think there's an item or two up the ladder.
Yeah, it comes back bit by bit.
Yep.
So yeah, I've been replaying Black Flag. What's what I find annoying in retrospect is how much of the plot you have to get through before you get all the ship-using mechanics.
Yeah, because I tried...
I want to get to the part where I can capture enemy ships and like, put them to work. But until you get to a certain point in the plot, all you can do is just nick their cargo and repair your ship. And if I put effort into it, then I want to be able to, start building my fleet of pirate ships. Thank you very much. I think there should be some kind of option for, if you've played before, where it just unlocks all the mechanics from the start. Sort of new game, but plus some additional features. I wonder if there's a special word for that. Mind you, I haven't played this version of Assassin's Creed 4 before. I've been playing the Steam version, which is a little bit buggy, actually. And previously I played it on consoles. But anyway, how's your week been?
Not bad.
You playing much?
I played Doom.
Ooh. Mood.
That was a lot of fun.
Certainly is.
I did not expect, because after the little, prologue section.
Bearing in mind, I'll probably be reviewing this.
Yeah.
But let's hear your stupid opinions.
Well, after the prologue section, I wasn't, because I didn't really know anything about it going in. I'd seen a little bit of gameplay footage, so I just wasn't, hip to the groove of what it was going to do. I thought it was going to kind of settle down to be a little more run-of-the-mill, here's some missions, go do the missions, etc., etc.
Yeah.
And then it didn't settle down. It just stayed nuts.
Yeah.
And it got even more nuts.
Yeah, it's a nutty one.
Yeah, I just had a smile plastered on my face. I was... That's up. Gun's got some kick.
I'm just going to knock them all into the sea if I can.
Yeah. Oh, you can. Really efficient. Oh, away they go.
And another one. And you as well. Pity we killed Del Lago. We could have made friends at this point.
Into the water with the foreigners.
Well, that was exciting. Of course, we can't loot the bodies, but who cares? Since we were so conservative with our ammo there, then I think it balances out.
It's a tactical trade-off.
There you go. See, you like you just throw your ammo at them like that one scene in Hot Shots Part Deux. You do.
I have a thing, like, a friend of mine noticed when I was playing Dark Souls... And, I'll be running through other places, I'll just still kill everything. And he's like, what is it with you and murdering everything in the game? It's like, it's just,
I do that on, the first time through, but if I'm trying to, rush through to a boss, continually, then I'll skip the mobs that I've already killed. But I've got to kill them at least once.
It's just that fucking reflex with me of just, in the old days, playing a video game was killing the things. So the idea of, just leaving shit alive, not shooting it, so...
It's an odd thing for me to get used to. Talk about mixing up the Resident Evil formula. Taking out the key makes the door open.
Oh my god. That resembles a cult
group's yes. Tummy still hurts.
Went to Spain and got one of their filthy parasites.
Shouldn't have drunk the water.
Bats!
Bats! I'm going to knife the bats. That makes sense. This is like the bloody bats in Prince of Persia, Sands of Time. They're not really a threat, they just annoy you.
Yeah. They're just there.
All you can do is like swing your sword and hope that they'll all die. Do these things hurt you eventually?
I don't know, actually. I think it might be pointless. I'm not 100% sure. It wouldn't surprise me if you just stood there for a while, they'd kind of attach to you somehow, but...
Well, let's knife something useful at the same time.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I think you could just get into the boat, because doesn't it just jump to a cutscene straight away?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, those bats just piss me off.
Yeah, they're not giving you anything, though. Like, I figure if...
Gotta teach them a lesson. Hey! Hey, it's a fishy.
Damn. Here we are with no pole. I think you can shoot them, but I don't think there's a way to actually get them.
Probably couldn't get them if you didn't shoot them.
You may want to buy a first aid spray if the opportunity presents.
Well, if we've already got one.
Well, I mean, we're about to fight El Gigante, so...
Well, don't spoil it. Now people will know we're about to fight something called El Gigante, and then they can draw the obvious conclusion.
It's heavily played in this game by John Goodman.
What a coincidence! I think we have something in common, Mr. Merchantman. Look what I found on a wall.
This is a treasure-rich environment.
He's gonna give that to his freaky girlfriend. What's useful against singing? Yeah, I suppose. Job. For some reason, I kept thinking it would have automatically selected no.
Yeah, I thought you were going for some kind of weird remix there. Like, gonna bust out some rough chip tunes. Is that all? Is that all? Is that all?
He doesn't say come back anytime when he's at his stall. He just stares at you till you leave.
Get out of my shop.
Come back. Then, because I remember where you live.
Shame the game doesn't have coupons for him.
Hmm.
Questions. For some reason, you find yourself teleported to a podium in front of a crowd of very important people who all expect you to give a keynote speech of some kind.
What a contrived scenario you're painting.
For some reason. Without any preparation and off the top of your head, what topic do each of you think you'd be able to convincingly talk about from Piconeeks?
Not sure I can remember how to fight this guy. Oh well, I'll just wing it and see what comes back. Yes.
Trust your muscle memory.
I guess I'll do a speech on why Bottom was actually quite a good TV series. Because I managed that on this very video once. went on for quite a while.
I don't think the world has had enough keynote speeches about Bottom.
Certainly not about my Bottom.
That'd be lovely. Keynote Bottom speeches.
Oh no, we fell for their cunning trap.
Look out, it's wood.
No. I only know one word of Spanish. They're just the interns.
I love how the sort of same dude is there three times leading out El Gigante.
Yeah. See, in Half-Life 2, they put in code so you wouldn't run into the same guy twice in the same scene. But since there's only four dudes, I guess there's only so much they can do.
Let's put a hat on one of them.
So here's El Gigante. He's called that because...
of his large pants.
Yes. And he's very, very fond of getting the largest combo meal at McDonald's.
Because there's no way that the pants grew with him. So somewhere this village has, like, woven or fucking knitted enormous pants, which means at some point someone was tired of staring at giant schlong. Like, that's the reason that thing has giant pants.
I'm going to preemptively say I'm probably going to die in this. I'm just not getting a feel for his patterns at the moment.
Well, if memory serves, you shoot him enough, and then the parasite comes out the back, and you do the cutscene.
Didn't you have to, like, trick him into, like, ramming the wall or something?
No. I mean, he's going to swing a tree at you.
Oh, so he is.
Yep,
remember now.
Heal!
Ha-ha. didn't want that. Okay, when he does that, don't be next to him.
Yeah, you want to try and...
Now we know.
Basically, put distance between you and him, shoot. Eventually, he gets a bit of a headache and the big parasite comes out the back. And I mean, if you got something like the hand cannon or something really well, you know, good and powerful, you can just sort of.
You won't have the hand cannon at this stage in the game.
No, I'm just talking in general. You can just shoot it, but at this point, you just want to cut it.
All right, let's green herbit. Yeah, I'll shotgun the bastard. Yeah, thanks. We don't want any, thank you.
Whoop.
Oh shit!
You can stagger him a little if you get his face, and there's a yellow herb around. But...
Oh come on!
Cuddle his fist.
What you doing?
He's gonna throw a rock at you.
So he is.
You probably could have shot him a couple of times there.
I want to shoot his face.
All right. Bowling for Leon's.
It happened again.
Big guy keeps punching me.
I'll just headbutt his balls and continue. Let's use another Healy thing.
Maybe try the. Never mind.
Hey!
Interesting!
Dumbass. Right. That's what we wanted. Wapa, 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 wapa. Is it better to do this or just shoot it with the rifle a bit?
I'd do that. The rifle's not gonna do enough damage at this
point. Well, I think my point is made. I'll be off now.
Sorry about calling you a horrifying lummox, man. I'd probably talk about something academic, history or teaching.
Okay.
Ooh. Sneaky. Oh.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bugger.
Point blank.
Bugger, 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 bum.
That's not optimal.
Bum, twat, piss.
pressure.
Don't pull the bolt back. Every time I do that, I imagine the sound dingle, dingle, ding. Maybe I should take the scope off for this fight. Well, that did piss all.
I'd heal. Like, if you want to live through this round, I'd heal.
You're a pussy, that's good your job. Problem.
Yeah, so I'd just go for something academic. I mean, I can... Which one of you lost your virginity the earliest? From David Untermond.
Aha, the true test of masculinity.
Well? Well, I was 19. But
ha, I was 18. I win. I'm the best man.
I wouldn't have guessed that.
Dingle, dingle, ding.
It is funny. Ah, good. Right on the noggin. Oh.
Well, one could hardly miss the thing.
Skull protrudence.
Not the sharpest tool in the box is old L here.
Nah, he's a...
Ding,
they breed him big and dumb on the farming planets.
And again.
Come on, come on.
How many times do you have to do this, usually?
I think it's three the first time, like you do... There are sort of optional El Gigantes later, but...
Yeah, there's a few later, aren't there?
Yeah, this must be it. Just remember.
There we go.
Careful.
Oh, I seem to remember that being harder. We didn't even save that dog. That dog could have helped.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
He would have said, hey, it's that dog.
Who, only shows up again here.
Yeah, well, it's not like you married him.
Yeah, it's just...
He's got his own shit to do.
I suppose. That's what the next Resident Evil game should be, is just all that dog.
Yeah, just the adventures of that dog. Now, if we'd, been a bit more artful, we could have got El Gigante to break these houses and got more free stuff. But we'll just have to make do with this.
I thought there was more free stuff if the houses stay standing.
No, I think if you make him break them, then you get the free stuff.
I don't know.
Oh, there's still stuff in here, I suppose.
Whole house's worth. And now the villagers have homes
to live
in. What
are these things? There's just like three empty sheds. In a little enclosed clearing.
Yeah, like right next to El Gigante.
Maybe this was the dress shop. And these were the little changing rooms.
Oh yeah, it's probably a market originally. Or a motel.
Oh, it's rural Spain. If it wasn't a market, it was just, you know, a pig fuck center. Dingo, 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 dingo.
There's a yellow herb and some pistol bullets.
Yeah, yeah.
Dingling is fucking.
I want a red herb as well.
Yeah. Because there's a green and a yellow mix sitting in there, so now you got a big one.
Bam.
And another yellow. Huzzah! Welcome to the Rural Spain Pig Buck Center.
Yes, please hold on to your ticket.
Yeah. Have all student cards ready.
Did you say the name of the person who asked that last question?
Yeah.
Virginity one.
Yeah, the David Untermond.
Do we want to go into detail about how he lost the virginity, or are we true gentlemen? Oh, it's, maybe we can go back to the merchant and buy the capacity upgrade for the shotgun.
That's using the noodle.
That's tactics, mate. Is Souls Combat about to replace Arkham Combat as the next generic combat system by Slow 64? Probably not.
Yeah, I wouldn't have thought so.
No. I mean, why would you think that?
Arkham
Souls
Combat's,
actually really complicated and hard to design. In fact, most melee combat systems are. It's probably why Arkham Combat's been reused everywhere. That's why, like, the lower effort games tend to be shooters. What are you selling? Because melee, you got to work out, you know, the swing, the hitbox, all of that shit. Whereas shooting's just point, and if it's not blocked, then damage is done.
Pew, pew, pew. What are you buying?
Are you giving me germs? Stop giving me germs.
Fuck you. You're the one that actually coughed on me one time.
Yeah, you love it.
You gross, disgusting sprinkler of a human being.
Do
you want to sell the TMP ammo, or do you want to just get a TMP?
Oh, yeah. Well, I keep forgetting, because it's going to get like £1,000. Pesetas, rather. Is
that old? Jackal.
Right, then.
Yeah, I think Souls Combat's way too, like, I love it, but it's also way too niche and unfriendly and difficult.
It's way too hard for a standard audience, a mainstream audience.
That and making sure that, you know, you can actually have interesting sort of enemies, but still have the combat functional and work.
Mm. And if you think of Souls Combat as just lots of rolling, as I tend to do, then God of War got there first. I roll like Billio in God of War. It's my first instinct.
Well, wasn't there that period where everything did kind of God of War's combat engine?
For a while, yeah, the whole like God of War but thing. That's
hey, there's a blue thing.
Oh yeah, so there is.
Probably wouldn't use a shotgun for that.
Well, no. Apparently if you shoot them all, you get like a firepower upgrade for the Punisher.
I never really liked the Punisher, because you can get like a way better handgun that upgrades to more power.
I
mean, it has the penetration factor, but
I like a good penetration factor.
Fair enough. I suppose it does go through the shield, dudes.
I like taking it up the arse. That is the implied innuendo joke there. I wasn't sure everyone was clear.
Pegging or organic?
What's the difference?
Well, pegging would be done with a artificial phallus.
That is a
strap-on.
Phallus,
yes, that is
it?
A... Huh. Otherwise, it's just sodomy.
I see.
Just having gay sex.
Yeah, pegging almost sounds wholesome, doesn't it? Sodomy just seems...
I don't know about pegging sounding wholesome, but sodomy does...
Well, it sounds almost jolly, doesn't it? Hey!
Oh, oh!
Shit.
Bad doggy. Does it kill the...
Which I bloody well hope so.
Yeah, it does too.
Puppy! Hello, puppy.
Yep. Like a policeman in the States, you are shooting them without question.
Of course not. They're rabid dogs. They're coming right for us! Fine.
Budge, I say.
Now we... Yes, it's going in the church time, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The brain-taxing puzzle here.
The keys are basically a complex episode of Sesame Street, Play School. What's going in the round hole? The round insignia!
Oh, it's got some triangles on it as well.
Yeah. Well, this is complex Play School. This is like Play School Senior.
This is more of a heraldic thing, really. Who have been the most famous, popular, stroke, recognized people you have met? Yes, that is what famous means. From Resilon 3. Why don't we ask you first? Who's the most famous person you've ever met? Tell you what, let's broaden it. Who's the most famous person you've been in a room with?
I've been in a room with what? Like, you know, I've seen The Undertaker wrestle, so.
Oh, well, okay, there's that.
I mean, the person I probably met would be Randy Pitchford.
Oh, yeah. I interviewed him in the Manor Bar, didn't I? Yeah. I forget from all the glamorous people I've met.
It's probably one or two other things there, but I can't really, I met the sixth and the seventh Doctor. That was nice. That was fun for me.
Oh, yeah. Was that at, like, a sci-fi convention or summit?
It was actually before any of the conventions had come to Australia. There was some weird Doctor Who traveling thing. It was something 2004, I think.
Wasn't even a reason to do that. But then...
Fun, Yahtzee. Fun is a reason.
Then we hurl ourselves through windows.
And Dad won this radio thing to go see them backstage. And that was kind of cool. Huh. That was where I got my seventh Doctor action figure autographed by the man himself.
Nice.
Yeah, that was fun. Well, and the sixth Doctor called me Big Chief.
Sixth Doctor, that's... don't tell me. That's Colin Baker, yes?
Yes.
Big Chief, you say?
Yeah.
How strange.
I mean, I was probably the largest sort of person backstage. It was a big collection of very skinny geeks.
That looks about right.
Sure, why not? I think next, one more.
Yeah, that's it. Let's keep turning until it clicks, I suppose.
Well, no, because you have to push the button.
Oh, yes.
I think that one's facing right. Yeah, that looks right. Because it has a little nodule, see, at the top. So I think you turn that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Yeah, that looks like
it. And you combine.
Combine.
Man and machine. Power extreme.
We're finally going to meet the other major character that we'll be stuck with for most of the rest of the game.
I think in terms of escort quests, though, this is still one of the better ones.
I'll agree with that. And you know why? Because you can put her in a fucking bin. And you don't want her bothering you with all the man stuff that you need to do.
Also, she gets behind you when you rear your weapon.
Where
in the door,
it?
Left.
Oh, yes, there it is.
Like, just a lot of little things like
Daddy's
that.
Daddy's home! Ashley, don't come! I didn't tie her up, you'll note, or lock the door. Take it easy. No! Get away! Is that a running in joke? She said, don't come. And I remember someone in House of the Dead saying that, because it's a kind of a dodgy translation. And I wouldn't be surprised if they turned it into an in-joke, because it's sort of innuendo-y, isn't it?
It's really hard to tell with Capcom what's annoying in-joke and what's just them fucking up again.
Oh, how classy, Capcom. What a classy achievement.
What did that say?
It said, secure the ballistics. Where's the
extraction?
I mean, that tells it all, says it all, doesn't it?
there's that question answered. Well, at the very least, the people who organize the shitty trophy names.
All right.
Even a good joke.
What is this girl wearing?
Wait. A crocheted vest.
Let's examine. No, don't do that.
Well, you brandish a knife at a poor girl.
Let's see what we got here. That's not boots. Like, that's like the lower half of a pair of trousers.
Yeah, they look like kind of cowboy. They're like leg warmers, but leather.
Yeah, like they're attached at her knee with little belts.
Amish leg warmers.
And a sort of tartan skirt. And two jumpers.
Capcom's baffling idea of what a belt does, which they put in every goddamn game.
Yes. Well, this has been the Fashion Hour. I'm just going to nick all the...
Judge a person by the cover.
Nick all the plants you've been growing. She's not a person. She's a jug-eared computer sprite.
I forgot how much she really does look a little bit like Trans Dewey from Malcolm in the Middle.
She looks like a little chimp.
Trans Dewey.
Hello, little chimp.
Really?
Right. Let's take the chimp to the banana factory.
Let's smash a noggin.
Well, of course, she won't jump down these things.
Nah.
Ooh, hang on.
Peekaboo!
I think we can do the thing.
Yeah, you gotta really get up there.
pervert.
Hey, what are you looking at?
Your pants. Fuck it, I'm not getting paid for this, you know?
Another one of those bits of, like, it's just the frightening amount of detail that's gone into our underwear.
Well, speaks the voice of experience there.
Yeah, well, there's pictures of it on the internet.
So the most famous people I've met, I was in the room, in the same room with the Queen once. What do you want? But it was just, you know, I happened to be in a station where she was making an appearance. And she got out of the train and everyone went, yay, because they didn't really know what else to do, really. Yay, it's an old woman.
Walked out, slit one of the peasant's throats, back into the train. Nobody spoke about it, as is British tradition.
If we're talking met as in interacted with and spoke to, then Gabe Newell, obviously. But outside the games industry, people who are famous outside the games industry, I once really got along with Brian O'Halloran from the film Clerks when we were both at a convention together.
Didn't you talk to Stephen Colbert at one of those internet-y things?
No, I didn't talk to him.
No.
But I did interact with Will.i.am at the dinner.
You know, on the scale, I'd say Will.i.am is probably the most famous.
Well, I keep forgetting, because that was barely an interaction, but I hung out with Brian O'Halloran all day. We went go-karting. Cool dude.
That's great, because that's in Clerks 2, is like him enjoying that as a way of blowing off steam.
I haven't actually seen Clerks 2. It's not very good.
No,
just then, in fact, I heard it wasn't very good.
Yeah, like it's... There's a few moments, but... A sequel to, like, what is ultimately one of the most indie of early indie personal conversational films is kind of pointless.
Now, Chancellor Palpatine's basically just come to say, ha ha, we stuck something in you.
I always thought of him as Philip Ruddock, but okay.
And you're going to turn into one of us, and basically our plan... We say that our plan is for you to go straight back home to America and infect the world, but we're going to try to kill you all the way there for no particular reason. So you're going to do it right now. We have absolutely no idea what we're doing.
We don't understand plans. We don't understand cause and effect. We're going to shoot you in the head with an arrow and send you back to the United States. Your father, the president, won't notice this. He'll think it is one of your humorous American japes that I've seen on the television.
That sweater tied around her neck is way too small.
I would not be surprised if they sold tiny sweaters exclusively for neck tying.
I know they sold some of Leon's gear as clothing.
Did they sell that rad jacket? It looks like it'd be pricey, though. I bet that jacket wouldn't be cheap.
I think they did, actually. I think they sold Leon jeans and a Leon t-shirt.
Alright, those are the two least Leon-y things you can really... get. I mean, that's not what I think. Oh, Leon's t-shirt. Like,
it's actually quite hard to deliberately or accidentally hurt Ashley. I mean, if you deliberately, it's quite easy.
Yeah.
But it's quite hard to accidentally hurt her.
I know, the game actually coded in well-thought-out fucking...
She just hangs around behind us like that.
Yeah.
And she does a cute thing if you get a headshot, which we will try and demonstrate.
Probably the last of the escort quests that didn't just go, your escort can just not be harmed.
And what I didn't like about Resident Evil 5 is that they tried to make it a full partnership. I mean, Ashley's strength was that she knew she was absolutely no use at all. But your friend in Resident Evil 5 was constantly wasting healing items on you and using up all your ammo.
The only way I could actually play Resfa, shoot the barrels, shoot the barrels, shoot the barrels.
Yeah. Fuck off. I
wouldn't have got that close, but alright.
That all works.
Bueno. In the face. That's right. Yeah, they kind of, because in, what was it?
Oh, bugger.
The kind of googly eyes that hang on the thing really, really add to the parasite's design, I think.
What I don't get about the Resident Evil T-Virus mutations is where the fuck does all this extra tissue come from?
Magic!
You dead yet?
Nope.
Jesus Christ.
I think 6 was really bad. There's lots of stuff that's going to disappear if you don't pick it up.
Yeah. I don't think it does disappear unless you leave the room.
No, if it comes from killed enemies, it will fade.
Okay. Oop.
Yeah,
prioritize that.
Precious shotgun shells.
Right. Now where? Oh, yes. We got Ashley, so we go back to the village, don't we?
Yep. Back the way we came.
Let me just take that old treasure map.
Let's see. Are there any facets of writing fiction you wish you were... you wish you were aware of when you started practicing from Ernst MacGuffin?
Well, it's kind of pointless to wish that kind of thing, isn't it? I mean, there's no possible way...
I'd say it's more for you to talk about things that maybe
practice.
People don't know now. So, kind of, it's a reflective question, I think.
You will almost certainly hate every long-form thing you're writing from about the halfway point onwards. But you just have to muscle through it, really. I mean, by the time you get a book published, you'll probably be sick of the sight of it. All the excitement that you had going into the project will vanish. Is it just the rain? Is it the rain and thunder?
Yeah, it was fine when you were shooting boxes and shit before.
Yeah.
This is a church. The church ruins frames.
I mean, you're always excited about the project when you start. That excitement will go away quickly. Everyone can start stuff. There's nothing special about starting stuff. It's the people who have the willpower to finish stuff that make it in this world. But you will absolutely hate the project by the time you get to the end.
Simpsons writers, one of the director's commentaries had a big long thing about that when they were saying that, like, you'd come up with a joke and you'd get a great laugh, the room would love it, everyone would love it, and then by the time you're doing, like, the third, rewrite of the episode to tidy up the narrative and stuff, you'd hate the fucking joke. Like, you'd fucking hate it, but you had to always remind yourself of what the first reaction was, because that's what it is when people are going to see it.
Yeah, it's a very similar sentiment was expressed by Eric Walpole when he was talking about when he was working on Psychonauts as the writer. He said it was a very disheartening experience because he'd been in an office listening to his own lines being read aloud by the game over and over again by people testing it all around him and getting absolutely zero response from anyone listening to it. And it sort of starts to break your little heart.
I thought that was funny.
Did we pick up any more shit?
No. Nothing. What are you
buying? Oh, hey.
Yes, the Red 9, the better gun.
I never used that.
Really?
No.
It's literally the better handgun.
Don't care.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, handgun's just a sort of workaday thing. It does the job. But when things get serious, you switch to your shotty or your rifle, don't you?
Okie dokie do.
Yeah, I'm playing. I'm making the decisions. Thank you. No more upgrades with the shotgun, really.
Nothing.
I think my rifle's still fully loaded.
Yahtzee, what's the closest you've ever gotten to not getting a zero punctuation video out on time? From Gedderman.
Well, I'm very... as I was implying just now, I have a great willpower for this sort of thing, or I'm just really, really neurotic. So I very rarely miss deadlines.
So it's a rather intensive routine at this stage.
There were a couple of occasions where I'd make the video and then absentmindedly forget to upload it. And not realise until I rather pointed email from my publishers, like a couple of days before it was due to go out. But otherwise...
That's funnier to me. You'd not, like, get sick, or you'd not forget to get a bit done, or you'd not maybe get hung up playing a game. You just...
Well, E3 usually fucks up my schedule, because I try to write zero punctuation on, like, Monday, Tuesday, but E3 isn't until, Tuesday, Wednesday. Like, last year, and I think this year as well. So I have to either write it on the fly or move my schedule around a bit. See that, Ashley? I did that earlier. This place makes no sense.
Some guy came in and was like, God damn it, and had to put a spinal back into the goddamn lamp.
It's a point of pride that I've never missed a deadline, unless, I gave warning because I was on holiday or something.
Well, don't you have, like, set holidays and whatnot?
Well, besides... like a week off for Christmas, then most times if I just want to take a week off to take a trip somewhere, which I do every few years, not a very regular
thing. I was gonna say the last time I remember was that gay cruise you went on with Jug.
No, that was the last but one. My last one was when I went on a trip to San Francisco last year. Hmm. Yeah, I heard dudes. Where are the dudes?
I think they're up the way you have to go.
Up the where I have to go.
Yeah.
There!
No, that's one there.
Whoa, that developed quickly.
And the frames come back!
Slashy, slashy, slash, slash, slashy, slash, slash. Good, you knew your place. You didn't get no explodey head bollocks. They literally are explodey head bollocks.
With googly eyes!
And bollocks.
Yeah, I still think this is the gold standard for what is basically an escort quest. Yeah, you she said is that. There, and she does like you can get her with explosives, and that's kind of where.
Oh, hey, what's that phrase that means behind you, idiot? Well, I'll just say it in English because I am English.
Yeah,
I'm behind you, imbecile.
Oh, I can't wait till you get suplexed.
See, your wife figured it out.
Yeah, obviously she's the brains here. Whoop.
Damn it! Going for a fancy knee shot.
Should just let her arthritis take care
of it. Conserve that ammunition.
Is there ever a point where the parasites emerge regardless of where you shoot them? Because I swear there were times when you could,
I think some of them are just predetermined to explode into parasites, and it doesn't matter where you shoot them.
They've resupplied.
Is the place fully resupplied?
I don't think fully, but
there's a few things.
Yeah, there's.
Oh, there's a thing. Oh, that's TMP. Useless.
Can sell it to Dwayne the salesman.
I don't have a TMP. I don't want one. Fuck off. Actually, it's quite good if you agree. Shut up, audience. Handgun basically fires as fast as I can pull the trigger, anyway.
I'm guessing there was somebody out there rigorously defending a mine thrower.
Oh yeah, you bet, man. What are you looking at, Ashley? She usually looks behind her when there's an enemy behind us.
Yeah, they're over there. See, there's that little desert torch to the right.
They're just waiting for us, aren't they?
Yeah, they're not active. Honestly, you could probably just check this house and then pop a few with the rifle for funsies.
I was just thinking that. Question me.
How do you take your coffee? From Eat Nerd Love.
Well, I usually have a cappuccino around 9.
I have a, drip-fed kind of Americano, black one from,
At this very moment, you're holding a skanky 7-Eleven instant coffee, aren't you?
Well, that's the funny thing is, even, like, the skanky 7-Eleven coffees are, not even that bad. They're average, but I've had worse handmade ones.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the rain. Look at their red eyes. Their starey red eyes. There's your friend.
It means they're full of gross.
Oh, get a better angle on your friend, I think.
I generally have a flat white. But at the moment, I've discovered that the milk has a way of gumming me up a little bit.
That's quite an Australian thing, isn't it, the flat white?
Australia, I think, per, population, is one of the largest coffee consumers in the world.
Where's he gone?
He's coming for you.
Yeah, where's he gone?
He's sneaking around.
What a sneaky
He's flanking you.
Bastard.
He's left. No, up, not on the bet.
You're not the other guy.
All right, how are we going? I think he's... No.
That was just a super headshot.
They have that long walk there. I think at this point you can just maybe get the shotgun out or the pistol and just go for a wander.
Yeah.
I think they've reset the man traps, though. Yeah, they have.
Yeah, this is what confused us. They weren't here last time because they only show up at this point.
Chunk.
All right, where's the other one?
Who was your favorite character from Undertale?
Have we answered this?
I don't know.
I'd say Sans. I like that he's got hidden depths.
I think it's bullshit they don't activate the man traps.
Well, them man traps, they ain't no team killers.
Well behaved. They will not get booted from this server.
Whistle while we work. Knife this stupid jerk.
Huh.
Oh, again.
Holy
smart.
Crap, he's in the Matrix. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
Oh,
he was going to breathe fire, wasn't he?
Yeah.
They do.
I have a personal soft spot for an unbelievably buff wolf just throwing ice into the water.
Oh, yeah.
Probably because he's so mysterious.
Yes, the mysterious wolf throwy man.
I like a lot of the enemies as well. Especially at the end of the good ending when you can wander around and sort of talk to them. Like, Tsundera Plane has a fairly funny little piece at the end of there.
Yeah, that's how the pros do it.
Twang.
Pros don't give no shits. They don't give shit one. Oh, God. Perhaps I could post my computer specs so that people will know how to use this exploit.
Yeah, somebody, because I don't have this problem, and I honestly don't believe this is, like, this is weird. This is, I think this is something kind of unique to whatever the hell you've got going on in your machine.
Bullet time exploit. Stay.
So useful. Just, there's a combat heavy element coming up. Get in your box.
Right, where was that?
Also comes in handy when the creepy things show up later.
Aha, it was by the exit.
Uh-huh.
I mean, the creepy things haven't shown up yet.
No. Good. These are just regular creepy things.
Alright,
I suppose the other things might be more crawly.
Where are you?
If life had a new game plus mode, would you do it from the nameless character?
By that, I presume you mean starting life all over again with all your skills and resources that you had by the end of your life. And then presumably emerging from your poor mother's vagina fully grown.
That'd be a fully grown, or maybe just a baby with a fully grown brain. I mean, either way,
it's pretty traumatic either way.
Yeah, I mean, that's either none you of it's
or,
great.
Like, for either you or for her.
none of that's optimal.
Haven't you ever fantasized about being back at school with all your skills and knowledge that you have now?
Not really.
Like beating up all your old bullies, who at this stage are just frightened and frustrated children, lashing out because of their miserable home lives?
Yeah, but see, I kind of knew that at the time, so... Especially these days. Yeah, I don't think a lot of them have had great life.
Aren't you so bloody zen?
Great help.
Okay. Well, I was going to use the rifle anyway, so I can get that capacity upgrade.
Yeah, do it. Do it. I mean, like, because...
Oh, wow.
Shotgun time.
All right.
Aim a little high. Might be able to get both heads. Damn.
Oh, look at that. Husband and wife team. I now pronounce the corpse dead. And other corpse.
Bury me with my wife.
Can do.
Let's see. I mean, with new game pluses, sometimes, like, the difficulty is also ramped up. I mean, isn't that the case with, you know, Dark Souls? Don't you get all your stuff, but also the difficulty is significantly increased?
Oh, yeah, but playing the early game with your late game stuff usually compensates for that.
Yeah, I suppose.
I hope you're dead. Trump's America. Trump's America. Oh, there's one.
There's a guy climbing over a fence coming at you. Like.
Yeah, yeah.
Marches toward a man with a gun. Truly, you are the bravest.
Well...
We'll remember you on Anzac Day.
There's brave and there's stupid, I suppose. Ah, you're dead. You can tell that they're not growing a parasite because they dropped their weapon.
Yeah. Do they still use the weapon at all when the parasites emerged? I can't remember.
No, I don't think they do.
I think it's just parasites.
They just sort of wander towards you and try to rub against you.
Yeah. Parasite has a sharp bit.
With their tits.
Oh,
more fun to be had.
I mean, I probably would, just because, have some interesting advantages. See if you could learn more, you know.
Well, better than... being reincarnated in the next phase of humanity when we're probably all gonna die because of all the ecological shit. I mean, that's what they're saying, isn't it? I mean, we'll probably be all right in our generations, but the next one's fucked.
Phew.
Well, unless, you know, full socialism now.
100% max.
I mean, there's probably...
I can't remember if they add a new neat treasure down there. I don't think they do.
There's probably a huge amount of problems in the world that would probably be fixed if there was, like, a guaranteed income. Like, everyone gets just 1,000 quid at the end of the week.
Will a flashbang set those off?
Well, it's worth a try.
Give it a shot.
We got a lot of the things. Apparently this would have killed all the crows last time, because crows only get one health. Not confident.
So if it does count as one hit, it should set off the...
Yeah, if it's just
like it does have
if
a...
it's just one health. That...
Yeah.
No.
Well,
you fucked up.
I think the blue thing's just above you. Like there it is, twinkling.
Yes. See it easier in the dark, can't you?
Yeah.
Bugger.
I think that might be sort of.
Bugger.
There we go. You may have to fetch Ashley at some point too, don't you?
Can't we just whistle?
Oh yeah, that's right. You can just summon her.
Yeah, like the dog she is.
I love a sensible follow character.
Come on,
what
chimpy.
Happens during combat? She gets behind you where she can't get shot.
Banana time.
Doesn't fucking goofily stand beside the enemies you're trying to fucking annihilate. Yeah,
Michael Jackson, crotch thrust my way over to this man trap.
If any of you could ascend a species of animal to near human intellect, what animal would it be and why? From Madame Marcus.
Ashley, what's wrong now?
Where are you going, Leon?
She won't climb down ladders either. In this universe, ladders are a mystery to Americans. They just hire Hispanic workers and then stand on them.
Mm. Game's a big complex metaphor for that relationship.
Any species to near human intellect, you say? Mm. Dogs, obviously.
That'd be my first thought.
Why near human? Why not human? Do you think?
I think this guy wants like a bunch of sort of, you know, retard slaves or something.
Do we still want to lord over them, or did you want like an equal partnership?
If you back up facing the door, the enemies can't come through because they didn't add a door opening animation. I think you have to defeat the truck first. But once the truck's done,
Oh hello. I don't think this is the moment you think it is.
Got a selection of good things on
sale, strange. What are you don't you always? I wonder what this guy's name is. Is that all? I think it's Eric.
Oh, yeah, there's that whole big bit before we get to the castle, isn't there?
Yeah, there's the whole siege house, man. And the boss fight with Chief Mindy's. And a couple of other things. I think there's even another Gigante, isn't there?
There's a possible Gigante. After the siege house, there's two paths.
Oh, yeah. Well, fuck it. Plenty of pistol ammo.
Upgrade your fiddly little Punisher.
Oh, because that's pretty low rifle, aren't we? Capacity, yes. Thank you. I always forget to press cancel. Oh, I want you to say come back anytime. Say come back anytime, you bastard.
Buy a first aid spray. They're always useful that round.
I don't think we've got enough.
Oh.
No.
What are you selling?
I have a flash grenade. Is that all? Thank you. Oh.
I love how hung up you are on that.
I want him to say, come back anytime.
Did he? He might have said something as we were walking away.
Nah, I don't think he would have. He's got to say it while closing his coat in a slightly pervy way.
Oh, my helicopter escape.
I like that we just don't have to show the chopper being shot down now because it's just assumed in Resident Evil. If you're a chopper pilot, your days are fucking numbered.
I think we see that happen again, too.
Oh, siege house time.
This is rad.
Yeah, we're a Leon sandwich.
Uh-huh.
Now, watch Leon and his party miraculously forget entirely about the besieging hordes. Right about now.
Oh, he's barricading the door.
That's all he's going to do. There's like another door and five windows.
God, yeah, you're right about the ears, eh? Shouldn't make fun of her. She can probably hear us.
Wow, she cannot make conversation. She just doesn't know how. This dialogue is so awkward. Capcom is so bad at writing. Yeah, and I'm going to bang her after this. Jealous. Oh, yeah, that's right. Ooh, I knew there was something I was forgetting.
By the way, there's like 200 other fuckers outside. We should probably...
Yep. Push.
I mean, dumb stuff like that aside, this is still probably a really great moment. I think you might have a second red, blue, red, green, yellow if you got
Yeah,
pick up those bits.
It's all them herbs.
Take.
I'm just making random noises because I'm panicking. You better take the lead.
Yahtzee doesn't think he can do it. I have more confidence in Yahtzee than he has in him.
I haven't played this game in years, if I'm honest. I was surprised I got through Gigantic.
Heal yourself up a little bit. And you should be fine.
Back to the wall. Back to the corner.
Check for the first one that explodes. You can take a few guys out when they start climbing in, and you get a few. You get some good easy headshots. Heal up. You wouldn't want to face this.
I'm waiting to be on red so I can use that. If you're on orange, pretty much any attack will only reduce you to red.
Yeah, I was nearly certain a lot of things have an insta kill from orange.
Okay, which one did I barricade first?
I think the one on the right there, the far right. Oh, never mind.
Ow!
Well, there's that.
Out of the way, please.
Heal yourself.
Yeah. I'm on top of things.
Alright, well, okay, that's not what you said a second ago. Just...
Well, I'm in the corner now. I'm in my happy place. Oh, we got thing. You know, Leon, you might have a happier time if you're out of my line of fire.
He ducks, though. You mean Luis, you're Leon.
Oh, sorry.
Achoo! Alright, well, that's good, because that sort of stunned some of the guys outside, too.
Bullet time.
Yeah, that's a...
And no more bullet time.
It slowed down to give us the... Guy to your left.
We're buddies!
Come on. Oh, poops.
Oh, bollocks.
Hey, alright.
Just wait till they're all ripped up together, I guess.
Don't shoot till you see the tentacles of their eyes.
Or the eyes of their tentacles.
I think you might have to start going upstairs. Like, do you have to go upstairs, or is there a cutscene? I think Lewis says something.
Yeah, there it is. Leon upstairs. Can do.
Maybe whack a flame grenade or something down there.
Oh yeah.
Maybe a... Bueno.
Yes. Okay, get into another corner. Hi, Luis. Luis and Leon, BFFs.
Let me try and... I think the ladder to your left, you can knock
it. Bye!
Take it up with OHS.
Ooh. Oh, hey! An opportunity.
Yeah, alright. Excellent.
Am I showing you up, Lewis? Oh, I was gonna kick him. He showed me up!
Oh. Have a fun competitive relationship.
What a rivalry. I'll have these. I'll have all of these.
Oh, that is useful. That is a good drop.
And you can piss off.
Yeah, fuck out of my house.
Yeah, my house. Squatter's rights, bitch. And you.
Well, I guess I'm just not using that one. Marianilla!
Please drop something. He said, use this.
Yeah. I can't remember if it just sort of automatically shows up in your...
Oh, I think he threw that pistol ammo at us. Yeah. Luis, when did I last use a pistol? I got you behind these guys and dropped shotgun ammo all over the place.
Yep.
Oh, bugger. Where are you?
Don't worry. Lewis is taking care of it. Good old Lewis.
Bloody Lewis. I'm the hero.
Me. Fantastic.
Right. Any more? Hey, push the ladder, man. Do I gotta do everything myself? Man, this never ends. Yeah. I think you'll find it does, Luis. Would you kill you to show a little bit of bloody optimism like us Americans do? Oh, we got him. For fuck's sake, Luis. Wake up.
Lewis has done so much work in this.
Yeah. Ooh, just in time.
I was lucky. I don't remember him being this useful, to be honest.
Okay, I'm on ladder duty.
Right. He's going after Lewis.
Aha. That's what a tank's for, bitch. He has to pull the aggro.
Mm-hmm.
While I take care of DPS.
Oh, fuck it.
I wonder if that guy who's just at the top of the ladder felt really put out.
He's like,
hey!
Looks behind him, everyone's going. He's just sort of awkwardly wedged in the middle of climbing in.
And we're magically downstairs again. Oh, look who decided to show up, now everyone's left. I forgot something. You guys go on ahead. Oh, great excuse, Lewis. I forgot something. Disappear.
She can flap her ears and make sonic screeches.
Well, I was wondering if we'd get to the siege house in this episode, but we just about did.
Hooray. Yeah, I enjoy the siege house.
Yeah, it's pretty much a culmination of everything we've learned, which is the good kind of boss fight.
Mm.
Still, it's a fucking unrelenting game, isn't it? Del Lago, El Gigante, the siege house. Most games would have given you a breather in between some of that.
Bah. There might be some stuff upstairs still that you didn't pick up.
Where were you when I was fighting all those zombies, bullet time?
Yes, okay, this is what I mean when I'm saying it's got to be something weird, because there was a lot going on earlier, and none of the frames dropped.
Yeah.
Like, you know, there were way more things on screen.
Nothing's even raining anymore.
No, clear skies.
What is going on? I was half expecting all this shit to disappear if we didn't collect it during the fight.
There's even some stuff outside, but...
Whoopee!
Slow motion.
Cute chariots of fire. Yeah, it's... something to do with being inside the house, I guess.
That's just a little face framed just impassively on the window there.
Now don't do it again!
Raise up. Raise that child like she's your own.
Well, shall we finish on a little sing-along? Just a while ago I was informed by Lord Saddler that our men had shot down a United States military helicopter. There shouldn't be any more outside interference for a while now, unless the United States government determines who the traitor is. They can only initiate very small covert operations. We must use the time to our advantage and recapture the girl. The two Americans can only get out of our territory by using one or two routes. This is where we will stop them. We shall make use of our forces to the greatest degree. We will deploy a large number of Ganados in one of the routes to ensure that they do not slip by us. For the other route, we shall leave the task to El Gigante. Whichever route they take, the agent will never leave here alive. Not with the girl, at least.
No.
Didn't we just do this?
Fine. Yeah,
oh, saving it again.
Yeah,
fuck it.
They give you a save point immediately after the chapter break save point, which I've never understood.
All right.
Throughout the whole game.
Now for a joke, I guess. Well, you thought of one for once?
No. Damn it. I actually thought, like, last week, too, I was like, oh, I've got a joke for this, and now I've completely blanked on it.
Yeah, I find that. I look up I hear a funny joke during the week and think, oh, I should remember that one.
Yeah, and then just pew.
And then I just don't.
It's
here we
vanished.
Are on the spot. And where are all the jokes now?
Oh, it was a bad pun one too, so I really liked it.
Now let's be a good Airbnb client and leave it how we found it.
Why has she got wrong eyes?
Yeah, I think she's boss-eyed.
Yeah. I am standing by the trans Dewey remark. That's exactly who she is. I gotta look Dewey up when I get home now. I'm curious as to what he's up to.
All right. Well, that's this episode. And...
Shit, now I gotta pick a path for next time.
What do you call a fish with no eyes?
What?
Stillbirth.